on iHeartRadio today. Also, AMFM247.com. Tune in, iTunes. We have a great guest joining us today here on our big broadcast. Graham is with us. Graham, how are you, sir?
I'm good, sir. How are you?
Pretty good, actually. Pretty good, actually. Now, you have a tremendous, tremendous new book here. Tell us a little bit about this book, my friend.
Yeah, so this is actually book number two, and we're calling it Dear America, Live Like It's 9/12. And so the purpose of the book, it's actually kind of made it very easy to pitch. I wrote this book because I knew that, you know, tyrannical dictatorships over our First Amendment rights were coming. The writing was all over the wall, and now, wouldn't you know it, the federal government is actually spying on Americans' free speech and collaborating with big tech to censor free Americans. So I did what any rational person would do, and I wrote about every single thing that every American actually wants to talk about and ask questions about in a book where they can't censor us. And that's what this book is about. This book is talking about where America, in my opinion, went wrong, where we've fallen, what we need to do to get back right. And we ask a lot of the questions that so many people sit back every day watching the news and TV and say to themselves, am I the only one that sees what's going on? Am I the only one that sees how ridiculous this is? You are not the only one, and that is my hope for this book, that people realize that you are not crazy, that America is still alive and well, and red, white, and blue-loving, freedom-loving, God-loving, gun-toting Americans still exist, and that's what this book is about.
We have got a great guest with us today. He joins us live here on the telephone. Graham Allen is with us. He's the author of Dear America, Live Like It's 9/12, and he joins us today here on our big program. So this book, incredibly well written. Take me through the writing process for the book, Graham.
Well, you know, it's thank you for that. I appreciate it. I never thought that I'd write one book, much less two. I would say that this book was actually a lot easier to write than the first book. My first book was about, you know, my life and my story and how I got to the point where I could even write a book in the first place. This book punches you in the mouth from sentence one. I mean, it tells you right off the bat that this is not a feel-good book that, you know, it talks about make-believe and flowers and all that other kind of stuff. This is a book that makes you ask the real questions, the hard questions. So basically what I did was I took from right before COVID hit and literally talked about everything that happened over the past year and a half and put it in a book. The questions that we weren't allowed to ask, the things that we all knew to be true, but Facebook said it was misinformation to even ask a question about, the election, everything. Everything that you can imagine is in this book. But the whole purpose is to show not only all the craziness that we all know is going on, but what I believe we need to do to get back to where America needs to be, and that's what the Live Like It's 9/12 part is about. I believe that September 12, 2001, the day after the 9/11 attacks in New York, I believe that that was the last time that we were truly united as Americans. And what is America? America is a group of people that are different. We don't think the same way. We don't live the same way. It is a group of every kind of ethnicity that you can imagine, but we all agree under these core principles that we are Americans, and under that we believe in life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness, that we're all created equal under God. We believe that we have inalienable rights that are endowed by our Creator, not the government. The government has the ability to not, the government doesn't have the ability to give us rights, and they don't have the ability to take them away because they are already ours. And that's the last time I believe that we were united as Americans, and that's the motto, the mantra, the mentality that I believe that we need to bring back into this nation to right the ship and take us down the right road, and that's what this book is about.
We have got Graham Allen with us today. He joins us live here in our big broadcast to discuss Dear America. It is a fantastic read, and he's with us today here on the telephone. So what are folks saying about the book? What kind of feedback are you getting from folks?
Well, you know, there's only a select few people that have gotten to read it so far, and all of them, well, 90% of them are people that read the first book as well. And the biggest feedback that we got from this book is that this book punches you straight in the gut, and you leave the book, closing the book, saying, yes, that is exactly how I feel, or yes, that is exactly what I was saying to my wife or my husband or my best friend the other day. We were just saying that. I'm so glad that I'm not alone. That is the biggest, that I'm not alone. That's the biggest thing that has come from people that have read the book, is I'm not alone. And I'm here to tell you that you're not alone, that real America sees the exact same thing that you see. We feel the exact same things that you feel. And I believe that once you read this book, you'll have a little bit of hope for America.
We've got Graham Allen with us today. He joins us live here on our big broadcast. Dear America, live like it's 9/12. He's with us here on the telephone. He's up promoting the book and doing all sorts of things. So tell us a little bit about, what are some of your goals for this book?
Well, this book, it started off to tell, I believe that we live in an America that has forgotten that the people have the power, not the government. I go from town to town, city to city, state to state, and the biggest thing, as I say to everybody, is who wanted to close their business down? Zero hands go up. Who wanted to mask your children in school? Zero hands go up. Then why did we allow it to happen? Why did we allow these things to take place? I believe that the governing authority within our country is laid out in the first three words of our founding documents, and that is we the people. Somewhere along the way, the American people forgot that the power and authority ends and lives and breathes and dies with you, the American people, the voice and the will of the American people. So my hope for this book is to re-energize that true American spirit within the American citizens that read the book, that you have the power, not the government. You are actually the government's boss, and it is you, the people, who decide what direction this country goes, not the bureaucrats in D.C.
We've got Graham Allen with us today. Graham, before we let you go, my friend, because I know you're out busy promoting this book and everything else, tell us a little bit about how we find you on the web and everything else to get the book.
Well, to get the book, you can find it anywhere that you buy books. It actually comes out physically August 10th, but you can go to Amazon, Target, Walmart, Books A Million. It's available everywhere. It's just Dear America, Live Like It's 9/12. For me, all you got to do is type in Graham Allen, and I'm the first one that pops up, so it's not very hard.
Well, Graham, I appreciate you making time for us today. Thanks for coming on the broadcast, and we will talk to you soon. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that very
much. Appreciate it. There he goes. That's Graham Allen. We are going to take a brief time out. When we come back, we've got more coming up on the other side.